Hello and welcome. Time to tie yet another trahörn pattern. And today I'm gonna do the Lang Syne. Really, really beautiful pattern. So hopefully I can make it look nice. So let's begin. So let us begin. It's gonna be a two-part movie since it's a quite difficult pattern to tie. I'm not gonna rush it, so it's gonna be long. Yes, you are aware. So let's begin. I'm gonna attach oval silver tinsel in the back. So let me just attach that one first. I got my heater on, and my dog is here, so it might be some background noise. Just so you are aware of that as well. So just tying in the tinsel here. And going back with the thread. Just to make sure it's firm. There we are. So I'm gonna start with a few wraps. Oh, easier doing it in hand. And you can feel the pressure. And that's it. Five turns. I think that's sufficient for such a large hook. There we go. So I'm just tying the tinsel in quite far. There we go. So I'm just gonna cut that off. Can reuse for next try. Just adding some pressure with the nails to tighten the tinsel. And then, as we know, it's time for silk. Golden yellow in this case, or same color as a topping. So I'm just attaching the silk, tie in all this material in the front, and I use the material to even out the body towards the gilt substitute. So I was interrupted, so I had to redo the silk. Sorry for that. So let's tie this one in. Tight wraps backwards. Hook I'm tying on is one of those very large ones that I procured earlier when Jon did the hooks. Building up the body at the same time. I should be sufficient. One more, just in case. There we are. So just tying in with a few wraps with the thread. Just cutting it off. There we go. So what I'm gonna do is to build up a base, a foundation with the thread to even out the gap difference between the silk and the hook before attaching the tail. Dog is making noises. He can hear the family outside playing in the snow, so he want to join them, but they don't want to have him with them. So there we go. Something like that. I'm ready for the tail. So I'm gonna use light wax. And here we have the tail. And I forgot to prepare the Indian crow. So I'm gonna just attach this one, prepare the Indian crow off camera, and then speed on with the fly. So just tie in everything here, really. There we go. They look nice. I can lower it if I want to, but I think that's okay. So I'm gonna prepare that Indian crow feather. So I got this feather, so I'm just gonna tie it in. Without it turning too much. That might be a challenge. Let's see how that goes. That's okay. Looks nice. The ostrich herl. Just gonna move the thread down. Here we have the ostrich herl. Just gonna see how it turns. There we are. Tight wraps. I'm gonna go with 4 turns. I think that's efficient. So just tying in the ostrich herl as well. So we can start to think about silk and tinsel. And in this video I'm gonna use the leftover tinsel from the evening star. So just going back with the thread so we can start in the right position. And these I can save for later. The tinsel, it's medium. So just gonna remove a bit of the tinsel. Something like that. Just gonna cut that one, pointing out, and we should be able to attach it. So just securing that one. We're gonna have quite a lot of sections on this one. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think somewhere there. I'm just gonna measure. Somewhere there. And somewhere there. Now I have a bit of control. So we start with the orange silk. Tying that one in. The same here, I'm using the silk to even out the body. The same here, it's a bit twisted, so just untwist it. Here, just even out the body as well, and I go forward. And then tie in the silk again. And then I have the next section marked out already. So there we go. Sorry about the shaking the table. So let's then do this tinsel. I forgot to read if it's actually silver tinsel. Let me have a look. Yes, I don't do anything crazy. Yeah, it's silver. So I'm gonna try to make some nice wraps with the tinsel. There we are. So what I need now is yay. So I have plenty of yay here. So I'm just gonna select a few. So I'm gonna do that off camera, otherwise it's gonna take too long. So finally, let's start with the yay. It's gonna be interesting. See how they gonna turn out. Start with some light wax. I got myself some coffee. I think I'm gonna set the pear underneath first. I'm just gonna move this one a bit. There we are. And then just even them out. Now I'm just trying to match the yay on each side. Not going that well. Never give up. think I need to maybe reset them. They don't sit that hard. I need to have some proper black wax, I think. So let me redo it. Otherwise they just move all over the base. Oops. So I'm just gonna pad them up again. Let me see how I tie them in. I think I tie it in this way. I'm just gonna tie in really firm. Sorry for that. Then I'm just going to pull it a little bit so I have them in the middle and twist a bit. That was a bit too much. Getting there. Tying this one is not a quickie. Slow process. And now they splitting again. Want them just to lay flat, but they have something different in mind, yeah. So I'm gonna reset again. Just gonna make sure they even. Might remove that fiber. There we go. Let's try again. Now it looks better. So that's the first one. I better don't forget my coffee. So let's crank on with the next pair. We're gonna have some progress. Let me have a look at that one, pairing that up. That could be something. There we are. I would say that's pretty straight. So I'm just going to cut the leftover there. And then we're going to move on with ostrich herl. Let's wax some more. Then we take an ostrich herl, tie that one in, and then we continue with tinsel and then orange silk again. Some more wax to the thread. One, two, three, and four. four times. Going back so I can secure the ostrich herl. There we go. Then we have the medium silver tinsel that I'm going to attach. But first, I'm just gonna make sure this is not in the way. Something like that. Cup of coffee. At least a sip of coffee. So just making the tie-in point smaller by removing silver a bit. So I split the A by going in with the tinsel there. So just gonna make sure I have that available. There we go. So what to think about now, it's a thick in the back from everything I tied in. So I'm just gonna make sure I have plenty of silk so I can even out that section. So tying the silk in. Just gonna secure it. I tie everything in. Tight wraps backwards. Then we have this section that we now need to build up the body then. It's too little silk, I need more. So I'm just gonna go back, tie that one in. Just some extra. There we go. So I'm gonna add some more silk. I thought it was enough, but no. Thank you. same here. I just use that to build. There we go. Untwist it. Somewhere there. Give it one turn more. Going back. Secure it. Looking at it from the other way, I might reconsider. So let me first undo this a bit. Not really beautiful. I got disturbed in my mojo by my lovely family running back and forward here. So four and five. And then cut that one off. Now we have that section in place. Just gonna tie that one in. Looking at the yay then. So how long do they need to be? So let me look at this one. That can work. Yeah, let's try that. So I'm gonna prep them off cam so we don't dip. Let's continue. I got another pair that I'm gonna try out, so let's see where we're gonna put them. So just pairing them up. Really sure if they are the same size. No, not really. Not that bad though. I tried to stick them here on top. Fiber pointing up there. I'm gonna reset that one again. Better aligned. So let's see if we can fit them where they're supposed to go. Yeah, almost. Might cut that one off. Let me see if I can move just one. Little bit better. There we go. So I'm gonna try to sort out one more to put beneath. To have something more round, I think that one. So let me start by just trying to pair them a bit. would work. Just cutting off a few more fibers. We have one feather, and I'm just gonna do the same on the opposite side. So then I take the feather and just put the other one on top of it. And you easily can see if they can match. And you just pull the fibers out. I think this one could be okay. So let me just prepare that one. Just cutting the stem a bit. It can work. Let me see how we can put this one on the hook. The plank. There we go. Just need to align them a bit. There we are. So at least remove the J. Wax the thread. Add some ostrich herl. And then move on with the GC. Come on, fingers are all over the place. Some more alignment to do. I noticed a fiber that I want to remove. There we go. So, ostrich shell. We have secured the ostrich herl, then I can add the tinsel. We got a big bump there, so I have a lot of things to even out. Removing all the leftover yay feathers. Had to sort the whole box to find a few that work. So there we go. I'm just gonna add the tinsel. Tread first. There we go. Just trying to get to the starting point. Tinsel out of the way, and then we're gonna do the clarets. Let me see if I can find a nicer claret. I'm gonna bring my silk basket here. Let's see what we got. Similar, but I wonder if I should go with this one. Really nice. Let me dig a bit further. Yeah, I got plenty of stuff. Let's stick with this one. And I have the same silk throughout the fly. Let's just take out a big chunk of this. Just to make sure I have enough this time. Just securing it. Then gently just cut the leftover in the front. This one will look good on the hook. Huge gap between. Just trying to. The good thing now is that I can see what I'm doing on the other side. So just trying to build it up a bit, even it out. I think I'm gonna stop somewhere here. Gives me a bit more room to play with. But for the next silk layer, I really wanna go quite far ahead to make sure I did it too short on the other flies. I hope I can correct that this time. So now it's easy time. Done with the yay. Just tying that in properly. Let's see, we had quite a lot of yeezy from the last flies we tied. I think those are the long ones. That will work. So I'm just gonna match a pair. Even the stems. It even can be put below. So I'm just gonna cut the soft parts here. Take out the neck to find a matching pair on top. So let me just wax the thread. We're gonna put this one on first. Just wanna make sure it's centered. There we go. First pair. So I'm just gonna get the neck. And then we can look at the one on top. I'm just gonna do the first one on top. And up here, no point, because the wind is gonna cover it completely anyhow. Let's see what we got. We have a nice one and another nice one. Let you see they're not too short. Looks okay. They're a bit curved. I would prefer to have straight feathers. So let's see what we can get then. That will do. So let's start work with these. So I'm gonna do the body today and then start to edit the movie, as it's gonna take a long time. And then we do the wing tomorrow and the rest of the fly. Just pairing the yeast here, so they have the equal length. Then just cut the stem a bit. Waxing the thread. Just make sure they are equal long, and then let's tie them in. Not bad. So I'm just gonna split them again so I can have one on each side. Might be easier doing my way first. There we go. So, time to cut the stems. So, just pulling them down so it's easier just to cut them off. This one is twisting a bit. So, time for some ostrich herl. A bit more wax thread. Some more backs. Yeah, securing the ostrich herd. Going back with the thread so I can attach the silver tinsel. Let's cut the silver away. There we are. So now it's time to add some more of this lovely silk. So I'm gonna tie it in the other way. So tying in the silk backwards. I'm going back with the thread. And then just wrapping backwards. Decide where to tie it in, so I leave sufficient room for the wing and head, etc. A bit more. I think somewhere there might be sufficient, to be honest. And we have a bit of headroom. And then just tie in There we go. So I'm just gonna cut the tinsel off, and then we can add the yeast underneath. There we go. So I had some longer feathers here. So let me see which one we take. That looks pretty okay. So let's prepare these ones. Ready. Just cleaning up the desk. So try to pair these two, we can have a look. Shorten the stems a bit. That would be sufficient size wise. So let me just wax the thread a bit. Looks pretty nice. Just gonna align them a bit. You see? And then just bend the stems so I can cut them easily. Just gonna do a few stronger wraps on that. This one is turning too much for my liking. And there we are. So I'm gonna omit that pair since It's not going to show anyhow. And tomorrow we're going to start to play with these ones. So, that was the first part of this Lang Syne. Nice fly, I must say, one of my favorites, really. It doesn't look much to the world now, but when the wing gets on, all the colors are blending in, it's just gonna be amazing. Hopefully I don't mess so much up tomorrow, so it's gonna look nice. Tomorrow I'm gonna go early and make the next video, the part two, when I finish this fly. So meanwhile, why don't you tie one yourself, or look and subscribe to my channel and share the video if you like, if you enjoy it. I'm just gonna start to edit it and add some nice reggae to it. Yeah, see you in the next video. Take care.